There's so many functional considerations that go along with the face. This is what somebody is wearing front and center. This is what everybody sees. This is how they're interacting at school, at work, in social engagement. So it's vitally important to somebody. It's important to their identity. Most of the time, it's this form, function, following one another, similar to architecture, where if something is not well proportioned or doesn't look right or is imbalanced, then most often there's a functional component that goes along with that. In the head and face and neck area that we deal with, that's frequently being able to eat and speak and chew or breathe. I'm very interested in computer-assisted design and how we can manipulate patient data in the 3D space to better understand their pre-existing or pre-operative diagnoses or situations, manipulating that in a way that will help us reposition tissues and structures to help us get the best result that we can. We start with the patient, their own data, their customized data that represents their facial bones. Then we take those images, we're able to digitally render them, and then we can manipulate them, basically performing the surgery in digital space. Then from that virtual space, we can generate 3D prints that we can either utilize in the operating room to help us manipulate and reposition structures, or that are sometimes part of the actual reconstruction themselves. We have a machine learning model now that's based on about 4,000 normal individuals. So this has come about from some of our collaborations with people nationally and internationally that are all interested in 3D morphometrics or 3D shapes of faces. I contributed over 100 of my actual before and after orthognathic jaw surgery patients to look at how we can better model based on normals and based on the after, the post-operative scans, how we can achieve that ultimate endpoint based on large amounts of data sets. This will help minimize the number of variables that we have to think about intraoperatively or that we're eyeballing based mostly on subjective criteria. We don't want to leave it to the hands of a computer to make every single decision as to how we're going to move bone and what the end result will be, but we can use this model to get us 3/4 of the way in terms of what the bone relationship will be and how we need to move the bone to achieve what our facial result is. I think incorporating this model into our planning process is going to help us get reproducible, high fidelity, accurate, very aesthetic results.